Rumpelstiltskin, part 2. The king entered the room, looked at the girl and said, "So, you're the girl who spins straw into gold. I won't do you any harm, but you must spin straw into gold for me." The girl was very surprised. "I can't do it. I'm impossible. It's impossible," she said. "I can't spin straw into gold. Tell him, father, tell him, please. I can't spin straw into gold." But the father said, "Do the best you can, my child. Do the best you can." So the king took the poor girl to a small dark room. A lot of straw was brought and then a spinning wheel. I can't spin straw into gold," repeated the girl. And then the king got angry. "Don't lie. I'm offended. You must try. If you can't, you will die. You should respect your king." With these words, he left the room. The girl sat down on the straw and began to cry. "What am I going to do? I can't spin straw into gold. Oh, someone, somewhere, help me, please. I can't spin straw into gold. I hardly have the power to do this." Suddenly, the door opened and in danced a tiny little man. He was dressed all in silver from head to toe. His silver stockings and silver shoes sparkled when he moved. He spoke to the girl in a friendly voice. "Hi, don't cry." The girl looked at him and told him everything. The little man promised to help her but asked her to give him something for his help. The girl offered the tiny little man her necklace and then she fell asleep. In the morning, she saw that the room was full of gold. When the king came, he was very glad. "What a beautiful thing! You have done it for the king," he said, "but you must do it again." And again, a lot of straw was brought and the girl was left alone. "It's impossible, it's impossible," she repeated. "But it is possible," said the tiny little man. He was just entering the room. He was dressed in silver as before. He helped the girl and she gave him her ring for his help. When the king came into the girl's room, he was even more glad. "You've done it again," he said. "I never seen such a thing in my life. This is the way to work for the king. Do it again and I'll make you my wife. You will be the queen." The king laughed and the girl began to cry. Come out, wherever you are. Wherever you are, I need you now. Come back, wherever you are. I need you now, come back." The tiny little man came again, but for his help, he asked the girl to give him her firstborn child. She didn't want to, but he had to agree. For the third time, the tiny man sat down and began to spin. The girl soon fell asleep. When she woke up, the king was standing near her, and the room was full of gold. Soon, the girl married the king and forgot all about her terrible promise. After a year, the king and the queen had a beautiful daughter. Then, one day, when the queen was in her room, the door opened and the tiny little man came in. He said he wanted the queen's child. "I've come for the child," he said. The queen began crying. "Oh, no, not that. Take anything, but not my child."